All right, welcome back, guys, to our final segment, which is what we've been playing. Mm. Patrick, why don't you kick us off? Like, what have you been playing lately?
Assassin's Creed Origins. Mm.
Talk to me about Assassin's Creed. How's it been?
Well, first things first is that Bayek is awesome.
Yeah. He's a really good character.
Main character is awesome. Yeah. He's less generic than... Who was the last character? The twins. Yeah. But otherwise, yeah, the character is pretty good. And the map is huge. I get lost sometimes when I'm walking through Alexandria.
Yeah. Alexandria is massive. But the map itself is really big. I finished the game without having touched three regions, I never went there.
Yeah, and the combat feels fluid. It feels a little bit more... You can take more risks than the other Assassin's Creed. Because, I mean, it was all just countering and attacking and dodging. But this one feels like I can use my head a little bit more, and it's more flexible. And, it's pretty good. The voice acting is really good as well. Yeah, but that is... expected from Ubisoft now. I feel like they're focused on character development, essentially. So, Assassin's Creed Origins.
Yeah, and you were saying, you're just going down the rabbit hole of side quests.
Oh, yeah. You're slapped in the face with a side quest pretty much every 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Just like, all right, one more quest, slapped with another one. Yeah. So, and they're really in-depth as well, surprisingly in-depth. Because, I mean, you tend to follow the... It's not simply fetch something or rescue something. There's always a story behind each side quest. So, I mean, complaining.
Yeah, every side quest has a really interesting narrative behind it.
Yeah.
Something that has you, relatively interested in why you have to go kill these people or investigate this area. Yeah. So,
and I spend a lot of time in photo mode.
Oh, yeah, me too, yeah. Are you uploading them?
Thing where you can see
your friends' photos and everybody. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Yeah, that's the kind of light online integration I like.
Exactly.
Yeah. I've been playing a big one, God of War, since it came out on Friday. No spoilers in this. I know people are very sensitive about spoilers with this new game, but all I will say is it's fucking awesome. Man, Santa Monica just totally reinvented the God of War franchise, and they did a fantastic job of it. It is so different, but so God of War at its core. It retains the brutal combat. It retains the epic adventure feeling of the story, and it retains the grand scale, because that's one of my favorite things about God of War is size. Everything you're taking down or everything you're interacting with is absolutely massive.
Without spoilers, does it start with Kratos's face on the menu and go straight into a boss fight?
It starts off with something like Kratos's face.
But it
keeps the tradition of the God of War menu start screen. The first three all were him standing or him with his face.
Yeah.
And this one is pretty much similar to that.
Okay.
It's really dope.
Okay.
And I should add, graphically, Jesus, this game is beautiful. It is gorgeous. I'm playing on a Pro as well, not on a 1080p TV, but it is just absolutely some of the environments that you get to see, because it's, I don't know if I can, this surely I'm able to say mythological setting. Can I?
No, no.
Never mind.
But yeah.
Really touchy about spoilers. Really enjoying God of War.
That no came
amazing
at the right time.
It's a masterpiece.
Yeah.
And the other thing I've been playing is Far Cry 5. I really wish I'd made a Let's Play for that, but Far Cry 5 is just crazy. It takes place rural Montana. You actually make your own character this time. You're taking down a cult, religious cult, who are led by this guy called Joseph Seed, who's got this area in Montana called Hope County under control. Typical Far Cry, but they've just ratcheted up to 11. You know what I mean? Every 5 seconds, something crazy is happening to you that you have to handle.
Oh, okay.
So I've really been enjoying that, posting a lot of couple videos on Twitter and stuff of the crazy stuff that's been happening. So, I really, really have. I haven't beat it yet. God of War is taken over now.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah,
that went to the.
I got a platinum in God of War.
Yeah, and apart from Assassin's Creed, it's pretty much just been Fortnite.
Oh yeah, yeah. We've been both playing Fortnite together. Yeah, so like yeah, we've had a couple of online sessions together playing Fortnite.
Slowly,
we're getting into it now.
Slowly taking over my life. Slowly.
Yeah. We had a lot of fun playing it together, man. Like there was that time
we nearly got our first.
We almost got that. We finished second and everything. And
yeah, but no one ever remembers second place.
No one ever remembers second place. Yeah.
It's a damn shame. Yeah.
Is that like it?
Pretty much. I played the new Ghost Street. On updates.
Okay, maybe you just want to quickly
with Sam Fisher.
Yeah,
and that was pretty much just a mission which was constantly reminded of you like every 5 minutes when you die. So once we went for that mission, you kind of just meet Sam Fisher and there's a whole huge gunfight and but it just got me agitated and I just felt like I wanted to play Splinter Cell now. So hopefully that was a nice introduction to seeing a little bit more of Sam Fisher at E3.
Yeah, hopefully E3 and rumors it releases this year as well.
Okay.
So I think that's pretty much it's gonna wrap it up from us. Thank you so much for tuning in to this episode of the InCntrl Gaming Podcast. If you need to find us anywhere on the internet, interwebs, InCntrlGamingZM on Facebook and Twitter. I'm Ole_Gunner on Facebook and Twitter. PK, you are?
Pato_Kafu.
That's both on Twitter and Facebook as well. So definitely give us a follow there. But thanks once again for tuning in. Please keep an eye out once again for those Soccer Comic Con notifications. Once again, we will be there doing a live recording of the podcast. Definitely come through Saturday, May 5th. Check us out at American Dome Showgrounds. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Be awesome.
But that's going to wrap it up from us. PK, thanks a lot, man. Another episode.
Always a pleasure.
Books. Thanks so much. Guys, thanks for tuning in, and we'll definitely catch you on the next one. See you soon.
Merci, Venga.